Francis urges world leaders to tackle youth unemployment. President-elect Nana Addo worships at Reach Church on New Year's Day. Welcome to News. Good evening, News Hour on GBC24 and Ghana Television. It's our first newscast in 2017. My name is Emmanuel Amagashi. Now to our first story. Pope Francis, in his New Year message, urged world leaders to do more to tackle youth unemployment, saying a generation was being lost to desperation. And back home here, President-elect Nana Akufo-Addo again joined members of the Accra Reach Church on New Year's Day. His visit was to receive the Lord's blessings, strength and power as he prepares to be sworn in as president on the 7th of January.
And we all agree that this is a man after your own heart. We say thank you. We know you will never forsake him. Father God, speak to him in his dreams, in his sleep. Father God, speak to him. Direct and rule his heart in all his endeavors in the power of the Holy Spirit. Use him to transform this nation in the mighty name of Jesus. And we know you're going to use him, Father God. Use him. We pray for your fresh anointing upon him.
After welcoming the new year last night at the Accra Reach Church, Nana Akufo-Addo, accompanied by his wife, Mrs. Rebecca Akufo-Addo, Alan Kwejo Tramanting, and other party stalwarts, were at the Reach Church in Accra on New Year's Day to give thanks to the Lord for a successful election victory and the new year. Nana Akufo-Addo, in the next 5 days, will be sworn in as the 8th democratically elected president of Ghana to assume the reins of governance of the country for the next 4 years. High on the list of the incoming government is industrial and economic transformation agenda, job creation and social intervention to be undertaken across the country to improve on the living conditions of every Ghanaian. The church service is the last service for the president-elect before his inauguration on the 7th of January. In his sermon for the new year, the coordinating minister for the Accra Reach Church, Reverend Canon Antonio Nelson, charged Ghanaians to wait on the Lord in the new year as he prepares the right path for national development.
Isaiah 40 verse 32, but those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will sound wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Beloved Lord, the text reminds us that the strongest of humans is prone to weakness and failure. And we all have that potential to experience times of physical, emotional, and spiritual weakness, regardless of how well we may have handled situations in the past. There's always the possibility that you will grow weak under the various loads of life you are called to endure. However,
we need to be united so that we can pray for him. We need to be united so that all his plans will be in line with the plan of God, so that it will come to fruition.
For the St. Teresa's Church, singing and dancing symbolizes joy and thanksgiving. At the Anointing Fire Charismatic Church, the focus of the New Year message was prosperity, renewed hope, and the faithfulness of God. Members of the church danced their hearts out, singing praises and worship to signify the appreciation for what God had done during 2016.
Christians across the globe ushered in the new year with church services. Messages that ran through most sermons was the need to have faith in God. The president-elect, Nana Akufo-Addo, who worshipped at the Reach Church in Accra, said oneness of purpose and unity are the hallmarks needed to advance the nation's progress.
The Accra Ridge Church, where the president-elect Nana Akufo-Addo worships, was filled to capacity. The congregants were clad in mostly white, a moment to thank God for his goodness in 2016. To the church, the nation's democracy was once again tested by going to the polls, but Ghana sailed through peacefully without any hitches. Nana Akufo-Addo was in church with his wife, Mrs. Rebecca Akufo-Addo, and three of his daughters. The coordinator of the Accra Ridge Church, Reverend Canon Nelson, asked Christians to have faith in God. He encouraged members of the church to meditate on the Word of God day and night so they can walk through the righteous path of life.
Beloved, the Lord tells Joshua that if he is to lead the people of God to rest in Canaan, then he should take heed of the law, the Word of God. We are being reminded that the Word of God, that is the Bible, is an essential step to entry Arcana, for that matter, the year 2017.
The Methodist chaplain of the Accra Ridge Church, Very Reverend Emmanuel Ayi, led the church to pray on a number of issues, including guidance and protection for the incoming president, Nana Akufo-Addo. Prayers were also said for the unity and prosperity of the nation. Nana Akufo-Addo, in his New Year message, called for unity among Ghanaians for total development.
Praying that there will be unity amongst us, oneness of purpose, that we can get our country going again. It's time that Ghana went through an era of prosperity.
It was a joyous moment at the Christian Evangelical Ministry at Pig Farm. The General Overseer of the Church, Reverend Dr. Akwesie Akwa, who thanked God for a peaceful elections, also prayed for a peaceful transition. He asked Ghanaians to change their attitudes and character to reflect the change they voted for in 2016. The atmosphere at the Christian Praise International Center was that of jubilation. Church members danced and praised God for good health, among other things. The leader of the church, Apostle Dr. Stephen Owusu-Jackson, asked Christians to serve God faithfully. He prayed for the leadership of the nation and asked the incoming administration not to forget God in their endeavors.
Christians all over the country last night crossed over to the new year with excitement and optimism. Popularly known as Watch Night Services or Watch Night Vigil, it is held on the last night in December to usher in the new year. This is also the night that people who hardly go to church join the committed Christians to be counted. The GBC24 news team went round the various churches in Accra to witness their readiness to enter 2017.
The Lagos Rema Foundation for Leadership Resource Development started their Watch Night service at 3 p.m. and ended at 6 p.m. They were joined by the Israeli ambassador to Ghana, Mr. Ami Mel. It was also a festival of light to the Israelis, a time that the Jewish patriots fled Israel from Greek tyranny. It is the first time in history that a Jewish ambassador has joined a Christian community to celebrate the Festival of Light. In solidarity, a candle was lit by people from Kenya, South Africa, Nigeria, Ghana, Lebanon, and Israel. The chief servant of Lagos Rema Foundation for Leadership Resource Development, Reverend Dr. Abubakar, said 2017 is a season in which God would reconnect people's relationships and elevate their businesses.
It's the year of resurrection of dead relationships. It's the year of resurrection of disciplines that you might have forgotten. But not only that, it is also the year of aggregation and compounding of all that God has ever said to you in the past and bringing them into manifestation and expression.
Members of the Reverend Ernest Bruce Methodist Church at Adabraka sang praises to God for helping them pass through the Red Sea in 2016. Attendant minister of the church, Very Reverend K. Quarty, thanked God for peaceful elections and advise Ghanaians to love one another and work with their incoming government in peace and unity. The auditorium of the Church of Pentacles, North Kanishi District, was filled to overflowing. They glorified the Almighty God for his protection and guidance throughout 2016. The district pastor, Reverend Franklin Wushi, praised God for his love for mankind and advised the laity to live lives that reflect the character of Jesus Christ. The Apostolic Church of Ghana Kanishi was not left out of the watch night services. They lifted up the name of the Lord in praises. The president of the church, Apostle Okoman Kralu, wished all Ghanaians well in the new year. The Apostolic Faith Mission International at Odoko used the occasion to sow seed into the new year. Many of the worshippers came with different heart desires and were in prayerful mood for the most part of the service. The congregation prayed for protection, riches, promotion, and spiritual upliftment as they entered 2017. A prophet of the church, Udifon Anakrapa, told the congregation that God would answer their prayers. Members of the Christ Pentecostal Church International at Fadama also praised God for his grace, love, and mercies. When it was just a minute to 12 midnight, they shouted unto the Lord with praises. The leader and founder of the church, Reverend Zulakula, said it is time everybody devoted his time to seeking the Lord. The International Deliverance and Prayer Ministries at Achimota showed their appreciation to God in a form of offering. They also sowed a seed for God's grace in the new year. The founder and leader of the church, Apostle Paul Oko Hackman, said 2017 will be full of peace and prosperity.
Many people find their way to various churches on the last day of December to renew their faith, ask God for forgiveness of their sins, and usher themselves into a new year. The story was no different last night as the year 2016 came to an end. At the Global Revival Ministries International, the church was filled to capacity when the news team got there, with the church members in full realm worshipping God. The General Overseer of the Church, Reverend Dr. Robert Ampiakofi, prophesied a year of fruitfulness for the nation and asked the congregation to steadfast to see the blessings of God in their lives.
God has chosen this nation in 2017 to make your life, to make Ghana become a praise on the continent of Africa.
The resident pastor of the Ashonman Hills Presby Church, Reverend Emmanuel Safobwating, asked Ghanaians to request nothing from God rather than to praise his name for seeing them through a peaceful election. At exactly 11:45 p.m., Reverend Dr. Kwame Vansa of the Hachu Unity Assemblies of God was in full spirit and preached about the theme, Your Shelter and Shield in the Year 2017. Reverend George Opong Onyina of the Rema Gospel Church International also prophesied a new year of good living for the nation and urged Ghanaians to seek Christ in all their endeavors. At the First Baptist Church at Community 5 in Tema, members danced and thanked God for a successful year. The resident pastor of the church, Reverend David Kwame, thanked God for the just-ended peaceful election and asked Ghanaians to ensure that peace and tranquility exist for the growth of the nation. It was a filled spirit atmosphere at the House of Love Assemblies of God Church, where the congregation praised and worshipped God to welcome the new year. The resident pastor, Reverend Kweku Akumbi, admonished Ghanaians to support the country's leaders in prayers and live in total unity to achieve more development in 2017.
At the Calvary and St. Andrew's Methodist Church, members celebrated the faithfulness of God. The senior pastor of the St. Andrew's Methodist Church, Reverend Kujo Obin Maxwell, expressed hope that the year 2017 will be a good one for the country if only Ghanaians exhibit deeds of hard work, discipline, and commitment to duty. The resident pastor of the Abundant Grace Apostolic Church, Apostle Felix Henry Dowu, encouraged Christians to live sacrificial lives and give back to society as Christ did for all. The nation at the Great Miracle Church marked the day with praises and thanksgiving to God for His goodness. The atmosphere at the Assemblies of God Bethel Family Chapel was charged with just an hour to enter the new year. Reverend Andrew Nelson Arintia urged politicians to steer the affairs of the nation for economic growth and development. At the Crossover Prayer Ministry, the congregation offered appreciation to God for His faithfulness and sustenance throughout the year 2016. The situation was not different at the Upper Room Assembly Church, as the senior pastor, Jandu Hedido, urged Christians to live exemplary life this year to attract God's blessings. The head of the Living Word Christian Chapel International, Reverend Dr. Andres Dello, asked Ghanaians to take advantage of opportunities available and contribute positively to the development of the country. At Spring House Chapel International in Dansoman, it was an atmosphere full of joy and praises. Worshippers came in their numbers to glorify God for His guidance, blessings, and protection from the beginning to the end of the year 2016. In his New Year message, the head pastor of the church, Reverend Johnny J, called on Ghanaians to live in unity and have faith in God, who at His own time makes all things possible. The congregation prayed for God's blessings and protection for the country.
At the Joy House of Peace Gospel International Church at Lashibi, it was all about jubilation and thanksgiving. The head pastor of the church, Prophetess Salome Menzel, said no matter how the year 2016 had been, God promises a better 2017 for His children. The congregation at Unity Church, Teshinungwa Estate, also ushered in the new year with praise and worship. The resident minister, Reverend Ni Ashikwe Kuma Olenu, urged Christians to focus more on God Almighty. The news team got to the Faith and Miracle Temple of the ICGC, Teshi Camp 2, just when it was 12 midnight. The service was held in the open as the church was using that watch night service to win more souls for Christ. The head pastor, Reverend Samuel Nyako, encouraged Ghanaians to work harder in 2017 for faster development of the country. The team was wondering what kind of song this was. It is a gospel version of the Unapo song. Members of the International Grace Calvary Ministry could not hide their joy. They were proclaiming that nothing compares with the Lord Jesus Christ. The General Overseer, Prophet Joseph Zawonu, said a new leader for the country signified the beginning of good things for all Ghanaians. Members of the Word Aflame Family Chapel at Dowenya ushered in the new year with praises and worship. The presiding bishop of the church, Bishop Dr. Fafali Seli, said God has renewed the strength of His children for the year 2017. He also added that the country's prospects have already been secured by the Lord.
The Global Evangelical Church Eagles Chapel in Poase at Dansoman in Accra also ushered in the new year in grand style with praise and thanks to the Almighty God for His abundant grace in 2016 and guiding them to see the year 2017. The resident pastor, Reverend Wisdom K. Aite, called on Ghanaians to protect peace the country has enjoyed and appealed to them to pray for the president-elect for God's grace and wisdom to lead the country successfully. The General Superintendent of the Assemblies of God, Ghana, Reverend Dr. Paul Frimpong Manso, joined the watch night service at the Jehovah Shammah Assemblies of God Church at Ashoman Estate in Accra, asked Ghanaians to eschew laziness and corrupt practices this year. This, he said, will contribute to the growth of the nation. At the Christ Evangelical Mission Church at Medina in Accra, the members also sang and danced to glorify God for his love and protection throughout last year. He also prayed to God to see them through this year in good health and prosperity. In a sermon, the parish priest, Reverend Loveland Atiega, said, "It is only God that has good plans for mankind. It therefore behoves Christians to dedicate their lives to God to enable them enjoy a good life." He said, as Christians cross from 2016 to 2017, sickness, poverty, pain, among others, have been left in 2016.
Bring you some watch night services held in other parts of the country.
In Kumasi in the Ashanti region, many churches could not accommodate the large numbers of worshippers who turned up for the 31st December Watch Night church services. Not even the tents erected, as some of the churches could provide comfortable seating arrangements for the excess congregants. At the Pentecostal Life Church International, the worshippers were enjoying a solo music by a member of the congregation. The superintendent minister of the church, Reverend John Jadu, delivered the national message. At the Calvary Charismatic Center at Asia, the attendance was massive as several innovative arrangements had to be made to accommodate the hundreds of people who turned up for the church video. Most of them had to watch proceedings from television sets mounted outside the main auditorium, while the Charisma Choral Group provided them with a variety of songs. Perhaps the Calvary Charismatic Center was the only church that made special arrangements to cater for both nursing mothers and children. The General Overseer, Pastor Ransford Obey, noted that Ghana has a lot to thank God, especially seeing the nation through yet another successful election. At the Ramsia Memorial Presby Church at Edum, the senior minister in charge, Reverend Mutsupokwa Jimai, said a change in attitude towards work and national assignments is the only way to help the new government to develop the nation. With about 5 minutes to enter the new year, the worshippers could not hold back their excitement. They ended 2016 with high hopes into 2017. They ushered in the new year with praises and later held prayers for themselves and the country at large.
Typical of watch night services, all churches visited in Kofodia in the New Drebin municipality were filled to capacity. Members of the various congregations sang and danced in appreciation to God for seeing them through 2016 and entering 2017 in peace. In Kofodia, the Ifiduasi Circuit Superintendent, Minister of the Methodist Church, Very Reverend Joseph Gali, asked Christians to have a closer walk with God in 2017 as they seek His peace, abundant grace, and divine intervention. The regional head pastor of the Christian Divine Church, Reverend Isaac Arthur, said Ghanaians must count themselves blessed to have held a peaceful election. He asked Christians to pray for God's favor and mercy on the nation in 2017. At the Christ and Kane Methodist Church at Nsukwa, the members prayed for the nation and all Ghanaians, asking for continued peace in Ghana. The Nsukwa Circuit Superintendent, Minister Very Reverend Kofi Anochi Ababiu, cautioned Ghanaians not to take the nation's peace for granted. He said Ghanaians must continue making the necessary effort to consolidate peace and unity in the country. The Amenuveve Congregation of the Evangelical Presbyterian Church welcomed 2017 with Bobobo music and danced to thank the Almighty God. The Eastern Presbyterian moderator and resident pastor of the church, Reverend Patient Boniayomi, charged Christians to focus on prayer, which she said is a powerful tool to defeat the devil. The Kofodia Circuit Minister of the Muzama Disco Christo Church, Reverend Paul Arthur, reiterated the need for Christians to be vigilant and steadfast in the Lord.
He advised Christians to maintain a good relationship with God to become overcomers.
The head of the Dunkwa Area Apostolic Church, Pastor Justice A. Abraham, urged the congregation to pray for vision and work towards its realization in 2017. He also advised Christians to put all their trust in the Lord, saying only Jesus can save. He also advised the youth to avoid bad company. The resident pastor of the Dunkwa branch of the International Central Gospel Church, Reverend Samuel Tete, also encouraged the congregation to look up to God and God only for all their needs. He entreated Ghanaians to be forward-looking in whatever they do. In the Western region, Christians and first-time worshippers gathered at their various worship centers to usher in the new year. At the Christ the King Parish at Ifiekuma, the church could not accommodate the congregation. The parish priest took them through stages of life and how to be faithful to God. At the Faith Alive Church, the head pastor, William Fifi Nelson, asked members to seek the face of God in 2017. He called on all Christians and the leaders of the country to be faithful to God. The congregation put their supplications before God and thanked him for seeing them through the year 2016. At exactly 12 midnight to cross over to 2017, the whole congregation entered into serious prayers for a change of life and prosperity. After some minutes, they all praised God for the new year with different kinds of dances to usher in the new year. Memphis, a construction company, also held a midnight service for the workers to thank God for seeing them through and helping them to overcome the challenges during their construction period. They danced and praised God for the new year. The chief executive of Memphis, Mr. Patrick Kwame Danso, said contractors must work within the framework of the Constitution. At the International Praise Prayer Ministry, the congregation was also happy to enter into the year 2017. The head pastor, Enoch Vessel, reminded Christians of their values and emphasized on the need for the country to remain united with a common goal to accelerate the socio-economic growth of the nation.
Christians in the central region, including occasional worshippers last night, joined various conventions and church services to say goodbye to 2016 and usher in 2017. Most church auditoriums in the region were packed beyond capacity, necessitating the mounting of TV screens outside the auditoriums for the worshippers to follow proceedings. Many were grateful to God for the just-ended peaceful election in the country. At the Wesley Methodist Cathedral in Cape Coast, the church used the occasion to remember the 63 members who died during the year and prayed for God's protection in 2017. At the Christ Church Anglican Cathedral, the bishop, Most Reverend Reginald Atabafo, admonished the congregation to put whatever happened in 2016 behind them and trust in God for a prosperous and successful new year. As if planned, all the charismatic churches visited lighted candles to usher in the new year. It was symbolically to brighten the path throughout the year as they held them and made positive declarations into their lives. The head pastor of Aiko Assemblies of God Church, Reverend Dr. Samuel Amoah Mensah, gave his New Year message to all Christians and Ghanaians. Prophet Collins Adams Hayford of Infinity Miracle Church in Cape Coast was full of hope that 2017 will be good for Ghana in many respects.
At about 7 p.m., Christians within the whole municipality gathered at various worship centers to welcome the new year. Worshippers at the Ho Ahue Temple of the Assemblies of God Church thanked God for his bountiful mercies. The head pastor of the church, Reverend Senyo Pungo, encouraged Ghanaians to be law-abiding and patriotic. Members of the Miracle Temple Ministries also praised God for his divine protection and asked for his guidance into the new year. The general overseer of the church, Pastor George Kunu, advised Ghanaians to put party politics aside and forge a united front for the development of the country. At exactly 12 midnight, members of the Elon Parish Church of the Evangelical Presbyterian Church welcomed 2017 with hallelujah songs. The head pastor, Reverend Emmanuel Ntritunfo, encouraged Ghanaians to have hope for 2017. At the Hobankwe Central Grace Temple of the Church of Pentecost, Elder Nicholas Mfujo told Christians not to fear. He said God is in control of affairs in 2017. On the principal street of the whole municipality, food sellers were cashing in on the situation. They were doing brisk business.
Earlier in a related development, the Takoradi Presbytery of the Global Evangelical Church rounded off its annual prayer festival in Cape Coast. The event centered on peace and unity among families and in the church and country at large. The moderator of the church, Right Reverend Dr. Seto Wofori, encouraged Christian men and women to make peace with the aggrieved, saying, "Peace cannot only be wished for, it must be worked at." The synod clerk, Reverend R.M.K. Atin, said the prayer festival is for the spiritual development of the individual. This year's festival was also used to induct a new presbytery who will steer the affairs of the church in the next 4 years.
And in sports news, the spokesperson for the president-elect, Mustafa Hamid, has urged the Black Stars to go for gold in the upcoming AFCON. Mustafa Hamid, who represented the president-elect, said Nanado's administration will do everything possible to ensure that the Black Stars shine again at the AFCON in Gabon.
The Black Stars held a closed-door meeting with representatives of the incoming government in Accra. Prior to that, there was an open forum where the two parties introduced themselves. The spokesperson for the president-elect, Mr. Mustafa Hamid, assured the technical team and the playing body of the incoming government's determination to push them to success at the upcoming AFCON.
The fact that we campaigned on the mantra of change, we will do everything to change what needs to be changed in order to bring real change into Ghana football. The president-elect wants me to tell you, the players, that his first opportunity to meet with you when you return will be that he wants you to be bringing him the cup. That's what he wants. The last time we were runners-up, right? Yes. So from runners-up, we should do logic. Runners-up to winner, straight away. We shouldn't expect anything less than being the winners this year.
Acting captain of the Black Stars, Emmanuel Ajimambidou, said they will not disappoint the nation.
The team is points for action, and the 14th round of the tournament starts. But with the quality we have in camp, the cohesion, the spirit, I think Nana will get the cup on February.
The Stars are expected to leave for UAE on Monday, 2nd January 2017, for a 12-day pre-tournament preparations before the championship starts.
And that was sports. The weather report is next.
The dust is still in suspension, and as such, if you still want to use your sunglasses, use the clearer versions. So we meet same times tomorrow. Yes, bye for now.
And thank you, Felicity, from the Weather Center. This is where we draw the curtains on News Hour. Thanks so much for watching.